Hi children, happy morning all of you. How are you all? Hope you are all fine. Good. I am also fine, Anna. Thank you. Keep washing your hands regularly and be hygienic. Okay? Very good. Today we are going to learn lesson number 1 in Term 2 textbook in EVS. Okay? Be ready with your Term 2 textbook and open page number 110, Anna. This page, Birds Lesson. Okay, the lesson name is birds. Okay, very good. Let's start our lesson. All living things need food to survive. We know about that. Okay, how we have learned how do animals eat their food in previous class. Okay, very good. Now let's learn how birds eat their food. Okay, Nana, very good. The shape of bird's beak and claws are suited to the type of food it eats. Okay, very good. Now let's learn different types of beaks of birds. Okay, very good. If you observe eagles, eagles have strong, sharp and hooked beak. Like this, Nana. Hooked beak. Okay, very good. Because they eat other small animals. For example, frogs, chicks and mice. Okay, very good. Next, sparrows, pigeons and peacocks have short, hard and pointed beaks. Okay, they use their beaks to pick up and crush grains and seeds also. Got my point? Very good. Okay. Next, parakeet. Parakeet has a strong and curved beak. It uses its beak to crack nuts. And hard fruits also. Okay. It uses its beak to climb trees also. Okay. Very good. If you observe a woodpecker has a strong and chisel shaped beak, means like a needle. Okay, Anna? Very good. It uses its beak to tap the bark of tree. Means see here. For example, this is tree, Anna. This is woodpecker beak. Okay? It uses its beak to tap the bark of tree and to take out insects from the bark. Got my point? Very good. If you observe some birds have broad and short beaks. Okay, it is sticky on the inside, like a frog. For example, swallow bird. If you observe swallow bird, it moves around in air with its beak open. Then tiny flying insects get stuck inside automatically. Got my point? Very good. Next one is Hoopoe bird, Nana. Okay, Hoopoe is a bird name. A Hoopoe has a strong and slender beak. Slender means sharp and like a needle. Okay, because they eat small insects which stays in the holes in the ground. Okay, it uses its beak to pull out them and to eat. Got my point? Very good. If you observe duck, you all know about this. Yes or no? Yes. A duck has broad and flat beak. It also has a tiny holes on the side of the beak. Because they eat small insects in muddy water. Along with worms, water plants and some muddy water also. Okay? Then the tiny holes used to flow out the mud and water. After that, it leaves the worms and water plants also. Okay? Then it eats only insects. These are the different types of beaks of birds. Got my point? Very good. Now, let's see about feet and claws of birds. Now, I have one doubt, Nana. Okay? Why do birds use their feet and claws? sweet and class. Let me demonstrate. Okay, birds use their claws to catch and eat their food, as well as they use their claws to protect themselves from enemies also. Means to hide on a branch. Got my point? Very good. And next, to sit on trees, and it uses their claws to go somewhere also. Yes or no? Yes. Very good. Now let's see different types of class of birds. Okay, Nana? Now let's see the different types of class of birds. Okay? If you observe eagles, eagles have strong, sharp and curved claws. Curved claws. Okay? They use their claws to catch other animals. For example, frogs, mice and chicks. Okay? Very good. These curved claws are also called as a talons. Talons, Nana. Okay? Next, if you observe sparrows and crows, they have 3 toes in front and 1 toe at the back. Okay, very good. They use their claws to hold onto a branch, as well as they use their claws to sleep while they perch. Perch means they can sleep when sit on a branch also. So these birds are called perching birds. Perching birds. Okay, very good. If you observe scratching birds means like hen. We all know about hen, yes or no? Yes. If you observe hens, they have 3 toes in front as well as 1 toe at the back. Okay, they use their claws to scratch and dig the ground to take out small insects and buried seeds also from the ground. So, these birds are called scratching birds. Got my point? Very good. Next, if you observe climbing birds, for example, parakeet and woodpecker. Parakeet and woodpecker. They also have two pointing claws upwards, as well as toes upwards, two pointing toes downwards. Okay, these birds use their toes to hold on a tree and to climb on trees also. Okay, as well as to cling onto them also. That's why these birds are called climbing birds. That's why these birds are called climbing birds. Okay, Nana? Okay, if you observe duck has 3 toes at front. In front as well as 1 toe at the back. Okay, but 3 toes in front joined by skin. If you observe our fingers, this is okay, 3 toes joined by skin. That skin is called a web. The skin is called a web. Okay, it uses this web skin is used to push water back while swimming. Okay, so these birds are called swimming birds. What are these birds? Swimming birds. Very good. Okay, if you observe cranes and herons, they have long legs and spread out toes. Okay, see here, Nana. This one, page number 112. Long legs and spread out toes. Clear? Very good. Because these are called wading birds. Because these birds can throw muddy water without get any wet. Got my point? Very good. These are the different types of class of birds. Okay. Now I have one more doubt, Nana. How does a bird fly? Okay, let me demonstrate. Okay, let's see about how does a bird fly. Okay, if you hold once a bird, is it has a light weight or heavy weight, Nana? Yes, it has a light weight made up of hollow bones and thin plates. Okay, hollow bones means there is nothing in their bones. Okay, thin means you know. Okay, if you observe the bird carefully, it is in a boat shape to cut through air when flying. Got my point? Very good. See here, Nana. See the textbook. Okay? I have one more doubt, Ma. We have arms. Like that, a bird also has wings. Bird also has wings. Very good. These wings have feathers which help it to fly. How does it fly? Yes, with the help of feathers. Okay, Nana? Very good. Wings are attached to the bird's body with strong muscles. These muscles help it to move the wings, as well as its tail help it to change its direction. Change its direction while flying. Okay? Very good. Okay, if you observe bird's tail, it acts like the rudder of a boat. Rudder means a small piece of wood. Clear, Nana? Very good. Now, let's learn about the wing movement of the bird. The wings of the bird has two types. It is divided into two types, Nana. First one is upstroke. Second one is downstroke. If you observe textbook, page number 113, Nana. This page. First one is upstroke. This one is downstroke. Upstroke means the wings move upward and backward. Okay? Downstroke. Downstroke means the wings move downward and forward. Got my point? Very good. Now let's learn about feathers of birds. Look at the page number 113, Nana. This one, feathers of birds. Okay, a bird's body is covered with small and fluffy feathers. Okay, fluffy feathers to keep it warm. These feathers are called down feathers. Okay, very good. The long and flat feathers are called, flight feathers. If you observe page number 113, top of the page here, this is a wing. This is a wing of the bird, okay? How is this, Nana? Long and flat. This feather is called flight feather. What is this feather? Flight feather. This one, Nana, see here. Flight feather. This is wing. This one. Down feather. Okay? Very good.
Can I
this come? This is about the feathers of birds.